Hello friends, this video on playing with numbers part 34 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam.
There is yet another method of finding LCM which is called the row method. Now when you look at the prime factorization method, you would see that finding HCF by prime factorization method is easier, but finding LCM is slightly complicated. So that is why we have this row method in place, where calculating LCM is very easy. So we will see how exactly we calculate HCM by row method. So here also let us take the example of 8 and 12. So let's say we have to find out LCM of 8 and 12. So we create a row. We put them in a row. We put them side by side. Like how you have rows of benches in your class. Similarly, we put 8 and 12 in a row. And then we follow the process very similar to prime factorization. So we look for the smallest prime number, which in this case is 2. So 2 4s are 8, 2 6s are 12. So we form another row. Now we repeat the process. Again, we divide it by the smallest possible prime number. So let's say it is 2. So this becomes 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Now again, we do it with the smallest possible number. 2 1s are 2 and 3 remains 3, because 3 is not divisible by 2. So if any number is not divisible by a particular number, so we leave the number as it is. So that is how we do it. So we start dividing by the least prime number, which divides most of the numbers. In this case, we chose 2 because 2 divides both the numbers. Here also we choose 2 because 2 divides both the numbers. In this case, if we choose 2, 2 will divide only 2 but not 3. If we choose 3, 3 will divide only 3 but not 2. So like we do not have a number which will divide both of them. So in this case it is fine. So we choose 2, we divide 2, and for 3 what do we do? Since 3 is not divided by, not divisible by 2, so we leave 3 as it is. So basically what we are doing is we are continuously dividing by the least possible prime number, which divides most of the numbers. And numbers which are not divisible, they are written as it is. And we will continue this process until we get 1, 1 at the end. So in this case, we have already got 1. So now we are left with 3. So we will divide it by 3. So we will get 1, 1. So once we get 1, 1 at the end, then we stop. So we stop here. Now what would be the LCM? So LCM would be 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. So this would be the LCM, 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. So this is equal to 24. So this is pretty simple, right? So this is how we find LCM by row method. So let us do it for a few more examples. So let us look at another example where, let's say, we have to find out LCM of three numbers, 15, 20 and 25. So we put them in a row and start dividing. So which is the smallest number you think, smallest prime number that would divide most of the numbers? 2, 2 would divide 20, but not 25 or 15. What about 3? 3 would divide 15, but not 20 or 25. What about 5? 5 would divide all of them. So let's divide it by 5. So 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25. So now you have 3, 4, 5. So you take any of these numbers, it will not divide all of them, right? Because these are consecutive numbers. So they will not be divisible by any common number. So let's say we choose 3. So 3 1s are 3, this would remain 4, this would remain 5. Now let us choose 4. So this would remain 1, this would be 4 1s are 4, 5 will remain 5. Now let us choose 5. So this would remain 1, this would remain 1, this would remain 1. So what is the LCM? So the LCM would be 5 into 3 into 4 into 5. So LCM would be 5 into 3 into 4 into 5. So this gives you 300. So 300 would be the LCM of these three numbers. So all that you need to do is you just keep dividing it by the smallest possible prime number, which divides most of the numbers. And if a particular number is not divisible by that number, so leave the number as it is and continue this process until you get 1, 1, 1 at the end. So this is how we find LCM by row method. Now this is the most convenient method to calculate LCM, and that is why this method is most commonly used.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple four-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates.